So one thing that's incredibly important to astrophysics is the concept of relativity, but we're gonna ignore that for a while. No, really, it's okay. Physics was around long before Einstein theorized special relativity, and I promise we'll come back to it later. Before relativity emerged as concept, physics was called, well, it was just called physics at the time. But now we refer to physics that prevailed before the 20th century as Newtonian, or classical physics. Classical physics considers mechanics, gravitation, electromagnetism, fluid dynamics, and conservation laws, such as the conservation of energy and momentum. Newton's laws of motion form the basis of mechanics. The three laws are as follows. 1. An object in motion will stay in motion until another force acts upon it. 2. Force equals mass times acceleration. And 3. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. We'll discuss each of Newton's three laws of motion in greater detail in the following videos. Newton's law of gravitation, another component of classical mechanics, states that the force of gravity is affected by both the masses of the objects it acts upon and the distance between the objects. Every object has a gravitational pull on every other object in the universe, but we only notice the gravitational pull of objects that are sufficiently large and close to us. Take the sun, the earth, and a pencil, for example. You remain on the ground because you are constantly being pulled to the earth's center of mass. Now, let's say you are holding a pencil. If you let go of the pencil, it will drop to the ground rather than clinging to you because the earth is significantly more massive than you are and thus has a stronger gravitational pull. The sun, on the other hand, is 333,000 times more massive than the earth. Both the sun and the earth are playing a gravitational tug of war on you at all times. But luckily, you remain on Earth rather than being pulled into the sun because the Earth is significantly closer to you than the sun. Newton wasn't the only contributor to classical physics, though. Maxwell's equations concisely describe electricity and magnetism. Bernoulli's principle describes fluid dynamics. Those concepts require quite a bit of time to cover, however, so don't worry about them too much for now. So when is classical physics applicable? Classical physics is a good estimation for slow, macroscopic particles. Once you start dealing with speeds that approach the speed of light, you'll need to consider relativity. And once you start dealing with microscopic particles, think smaller than an atom, you'll need to turn to quantum physics.